One of the reasons we're fascinated by primes is that they're quite weird in the way they behave. On one hand, they kind of feel random. They're turning up all over the place. Sometimes you have these long gaps between primes, and then suddenly, you like buses, you get a couple of primes turn up at once. On the other hand, there are things that we can predict about primes and when they're going to turn up, which is slightly unexpected that you can do that. They're not completely random. One of the first things I want to show you then is quite nice. It's a nice, easy thing, so everyone can do this at home. We're going to write the numbers in a square spiral. You start with one in the middle, then you write two, but you go around it, four, five, six, seven, eight. Do you see the pattern then? It's a square spiral, 12, 13, 14, 15. It's called an Ulam spiral. It's Stanisław Ulam. He was a Polish mathematician, and he left Poland just before World War II, and he went to America, and he worked on the Manhattan Project. After World War II, he went into academia. The story of this spiral is he was sat in a very boring lecture in academia. It was in 1963, and so he's obviously a fan of Weishaupt or someone. He sat there doodling during this boring lecture. And he's writing out the numbers. Let's do 30, 31, 32. The next thing he did was start to circle the prime numbers. So let's do that. 2 is a prime, and then 3, and then 5, and 7, and 11, 13, not 40, 41, 43 is prime, and so on. And he noticed, and maybe you can see, these stripes, the prime numbers seem to be lining up on diagonal lines. And if you do this larger, if you do more and more numbers and you write them out in a spiral, that tends to be the case. I've got one here. This is a big Ulam spiral. I think this is something huge. I think this is like 200 by 200. And so there's 40,000 numbers or something here. Can you see though? Can you see the stripes? There's definitely some stripes here, these diagonal lines. So the prime numbers seem to be lying on diagonal lines. Or to put it another way, some diagonal lines have lots of primes and some diagonal lines don't have lots of primes. So you can see the stripes start to form.
Are they continuous stripes? They look a bit broken up to me.
Yeah, they're not continuous stripes, but they have more than average number of primes. So these stripes might be a good place to look for more primes, bigger primes, new primes. One thing people might say is, oh, we're just seeing patterns in randomness. That those aren't really stripes at all. It's just the human brain. If you compare it with randomness, this here are same size, these are random numbers. And you can see it's pretty much white noise. I can't really see any pattern in this. You can see that that is random. And you can see that that is something more than just being random.
These ginormous primes that get found, are they found on diagonals? Like this largest prime known, was that on a diagonal?
The largest prime known was a Mersenne prime, which is of the type 2 to the power n minus 1. It's one less than a power of 2, which is a way to look for large primes. It's computationally, it's kind of easier to do. It's not the most fruitful way because they're quite rare, Mersenne primes. This might be another way to do it because this stripe here, this diagonal, has an equation. This equation is for this one here, this half line, which means it starts at 3 and goes off to infinity. The equation for that is 4x squared minus 2x plus 1. Let me just try it. Let's do the first one here. So if x is equal to 1, yeah, that's 3. If we tried the next one here, x equals 2, it's 13. And this one here, that's 31. And, well, let's do one more just to show you what comes next. 56 plus 57. Is that a prime number, Brady?
57 is not a prime number.
It's not a prime number. So the next one isn't a prime number, but 57 would be the next number on that line.
So that's one of the breaks in our dotted line.
Yeah. So all these lines, in fact, horizontal lines, vertical lines, and diagonal lines, they're all like this. They're all quadratic equations. They're like that. So what we're saying is some quadratic equations have more primes on them than others. And that's the conjecture, actually. That hasn't been proved, but that is the conjecture. It seems to be the case. So there are lines here that have like seven times as many primes as other lines. And there are the best we've found is a diagonal line that has 12 times as many primes as the average.
Cool. Has that line got a name?
I can write it out for you. I think I had it somewhere.
Yeah, I'd love to know what that line is. The golden line.
This golden line that Brady has now decided to call it, it actually starts off, it's a quadratic equation. It starts off quite simply, again, but the number you add on is not plus one, it's plus something huge. This square spiral is called Ulam spiral, but there's one that I like even more. It's called a Sac spiral, and it works like this. You write the square numbers in a line. The square numbers are 1, 4, yeah, that is 2 squared, 3 squared is 9, 16, 25, and so on. So you write the square numbers in a line, then I connect them with what is called an Archimedean spiral, like that. And then I would put the other numbers on that spiral. So it would go 1, I'd evenly space it. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if you mark off the primes for that, I've got this already sorted out for you. This is the picture you get. And you can see the relations, you can see the pattern even more strikingly, I think. Look at these curves. These are the primes.
And obviously you'll never get a prime along there because they're squares.
And those are your squares. That big gap there is the squares, yeah. So it looks like we have formulas, equations that have, some formulas anyway, that have more primes than others. So if we can understand these formulas that contain these rich number of primes, then it would help us solve important conjectures in mathematics such as the Goldbach conjecture and the twin prime conjecture. So prime numbers are not as random as you might think of. There are equations to help us find prime numbers. And now I want to show you some equations that help you find prime numbers.
So we'll have more about ways to search for prime numbers coming really soon from this interview with James Grime. Unless you're watching this in the future, in which case the stuff might already be on YouTube. But you get the idea. But I have a bit of a confession to make. I've actually recorded some stuff about these spirals and prime numbers before, not with James Grime, but with James Cluett. And I kind of half forgot about it and never got around to editing it. This was like a year and a half ago. I went back and had a look, and it was actually really interesting. So I've turned that into a video as well. Now you can wait for that to turn up in your subscriptions in the next few days, or if you can't wait, you can go and have a look at it now. I've made the links available, the video is already up, so go ahead and have a look. Thanks for watching, plenty more videos soon, both of stuff I've recorded, some of it quite a while ago it turns out, and stuff we've still got to record. Really exciting stuff coming soon on Numberphile, so make sure you've subscribed.